அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். எஸ் ராஜரத்னம், சேர்மேன் தமிழ்நாடு ஃபவுண்டேஷன், டாக்டர் சோம்லை சோம் சுந்தரம், பிரசிடென்ட் தமிழ்நாடு ஃபவுண்டேஷன் யுஎஸ்ஏ, திரு என் முரளி, சேர்மன் கஸ்தூரியன் சன்ஸ், பிரசிடென்ட் த மியூசிக் அகாடமி, டாக்டர் பழனிஜி பெரியசாமி, சேர்மன் பிஜிபி எஜுகேஷன் வெல்ஃபேர் சொசைட்டி, சேர்மன் லி ராயல் மெரிடியன், டிஸ்டிங்விஷ்ட் இன்வைட்டி, லேடிஸ் அண்ட் ஜென்டில்மேன், ஐ எம் ஹாப்பி டு பி ஹியர் ஃபார் த அனுவல் டே செலிப்ரேஷன் ஃபார் த தமிழ்நாடு ஃபவுண்டேஷன். A charitable trust is started by a few patriotic young American Tamils in the year 1974. What started as a mere building has grown to gargantuan proportions, and today the Tamil Nadu Foundation, with the liberal contribution of its members and their families, can boast of improving the lives of more than 2 lakh people, covered under 600 projects implemented in the last 4 decades in Tamil Nadu. The achievement of the people of Tamil Nadu in foreign nations have been praiseworthy and unparalleled all through the ages. திரை கடல் ஓடியம் திரவியம் டெடு ஓல்ட் தமிழ் சேம் இட் டிரான்ஸ்லேட்ஸ் டு மீன் தட் ஒன் ஷுட் நாட் ஹெசிடேட் டு க்ராஸ் ஈவன் த செவன் சீன்ஸ் இன் த குவெஸ்ட் ஃபார் வெல்த். நோ வண்டர் ஹிஸ்டரி ஹேஸ் டாக்குமெண்டட் ரெக்கார்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஷிப்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் யூரோப் டச்சிங் த கோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தமிழ்நாடு அட் த போர்ட் ஆஃப் Kaveri Poom, Pattivam, located at the mouth of the Kaveri River. Sirpadikaram makes a mention of the prosperity of Ompukar, where Golan and Kanakki lived, and to how business and trade has resulted in the prosperity of Golan's family. At subsequent points of time in history, one hears of the Chola King extending their domination in Sri Lanka, Indonesia, and many other parts of Southeast Asia. Therefore, it should come as no surprise for anyone to know that Tamilians were among the early settlers in Singapore and Malaysia. I'm sure that all of you know about the Mariamman temple and the predominant Tamil population in Little India in Singapore. The United States has the largest Indian population in the world outside Asia. Indian immigration to North America started as early as the 1890s. Christian women were restricted from immigrating because the US government passed laws in 1917. At the behest of California and other states in the West, which had experienced a large influx of Chinese, Japanese, and Indian immigrants during and after the Gold Rush. After World War II, US immigration policy changed. After almost a half century to allow family reunification, in addition, Asians were allowed to become citizens and to vote. A wave of Indian immigrants entered the U.S. After independence, a large proportion of them went there to join their family members under the new immigration laws. The need for engineers in the defense and aerospace industries in the USA attracted many talented people from India. by the late 1980s and early 1990s, large numbers of professionals had settled in the US. There is a tremendous rush, I think, since last, I'm running engineering college also. So since last 30 years I have observed that from various streams, almost 10% students, they are selected in USA and they got the job for higher studies and all that. And they are doing wonderfully well and most successful. Even doctors are respected very much. Indians in states and European countries and Canada, they are commanding a tremendous respect, I tell you, because of their honesty, sincere and dedication. That is the quality which no other. The most recent and probably the largest wave organization, it occurred in the late 1990s and early 2000s during the internet boom. As a result, Indians in the US are now one of the largest among the groups of immigrants, with the estimated population of about 3.2 million, or 1% of the US population, according to American Community Survey of 2010 data. Of this Asian Indian population, professionals from Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Gujarat constitute a considerable number. The state of California has lakhs of Tamilians working in the software industry, and today many multinational companies such as Google's are proud to have Tamilians head their global activities. Tamilians are in general known for their friendly nature, their hospitality, their hard-working nature, intelligence and selfless service. You may all like to go back to history. In history, to recall that the first three Bharat Ratna awards in the 50s were given to three Tamilians, namely Rajaji, C.V. Raman and S. Radhakrishnan. First three awards. In the subsequent decades also, the state has produced giants in all aspects of societal engagement, be it politics, drama, dance or literature. In recent decades, there has been perennial prosperity accruing to the state thanks to the remittances being made by NRI Tamil for the benefit of their families back home. It is a matter of greater satisfaction to see NRI Tamils living in USA have been rendering support and assistance to enable less privileged Tamils in the state to gain access to educational opportunities. The NRI Supported Trust Tamil Nadu Foundation has rightly focused on strengthening school education, particularly in rural government schools. This is not working, particularly because most of the farmers and poor people, they get benefit directly because of that. To enhance the quality of education in rural areas, Tamil Nadu Foundation adopted 51 government schools in 9 districts, covering nearly 5,000 children who are academically backward. I am given to understand that Tamil Nadu Foundation is the only NGO in the Tamil Nadu which is assisting in the provision of quality education in government schools within the school campus and within the school timings through a MOU signed by the Director of School Education. This is really creditable. I know you find the foundation and the government is between. You won't find anywhere else in other states. Heads up to you. And MESS, fundraising concept. Mund Vasnai is being launched today under the auspices of the Tamil Nadu Foundation. Mund Vasnai is being launched today under the auspices of the Tamil Nadu Foundation. It demonstrates the extent to which NRI Tamils, particularly settled in the USA, are keen to provide a helping hand to their brother named Tamil Nadu. This will enable donors USA to contribute to projects for the development of their native districts in Tamil Nadu. The Tamil Nadu Foundation will be thus raising corpus fund for each district. The word of caution I tell you. Election is very near. All the parties will, they will approach individually to all the NRI for their funds waiting. You send a circular, no funds to be given to any political party. Because that is not used properly.
Yes.
That is used to bribe the voters. Because the expenses have been regulated by the election commission. The money allotted to each candidate is enough for, because he must be having in his own pocket. He need not go for donation and all that. So donation he can collect from his friends also, but not from the NRI. The NRI you reserve for your foundation only. Tell them. The district focused corporation that will be set up for each of the 30 districts of Tamil Nadu. Because you will need a lot of funds now. So that you try to divert it from the political side to this, for the noble cause. And I think Mr. Murli, through the Hindu, he will help definitely.
Sure.
The bulk of Indian populations still live in the villages, and agriculture is the mainstay of the rural economy. Though India is self-sufficient in food production, we need to focus on increased availability of civic amenities in the rural area. Tamil Nadu is one of the better endowed states with a widespread network of schools. Electrification having been completed in almost all villages and with the excellent road and rail network. I have seen personally, that's why I have mentioned here. This state is more progressive. You know, I am from Maharashtra. Before coming over here, I was under the clear-cut impression that Maharashtra is the top in the country. Now coming over here, visiting almost all the district, I think two left, no?
Yes.
Only two left. All the district I have covered, that too extensively, by road, everything, I am watching everything, interacting with the people. Now I am sure you are one head than Maharashtra. I have no hesitation. If one goes back one or two generations, one will find that the Indians residing in cities abroad owe their origin to one village on the other. It was the village, its water, and the open countryside that has given them the physical constitution and mental capabilities to make it big. In life, it is time for them to repay their debt by contributing in their own small way to the extent possible. If this were to be done by every such individual and family, Indian countryside will see prosperity of an order that it has not witnessed before. I am sure that this trend is catching on. As India grows in economic prosperity, there is going to be increased contribution towards the rural sector, paving the way for inclusive growth. I congratulate the Tamil Nadu Foundation for shown remarkable results in this direction. The projects launched by them are trendsetters for the nation. I wish them well, wish that they should be greeted with success in all their endeavors. May God Almighty shower His blessings on them in plenty. Nandri Vanakkam.
We thank our Honorable Governor for his inspiring speech. We now invite Mr. V.